Welcome to our 16th video in the QuickBooks Home Finance series, Loan Management or Goal Setting. The loan manager will tell you any information you need to know about any loan that you might take. You should tell the loan manager how much you are borrowing, what interest rate you're borrowing at, and then you will decide how many payments you would like to make. Then the loan manager will tell you how much of each payment is interest and how much of each payment is principal. It will let you know if you have to make any balloon payment at the end. This means if the number of payments you would like to make will not pay off the loan, based on the information that was given, that means at the end you might have to pay off the rest of the loan. And it will also help you adjust for the correct number of periods. You can use it for taxes so that you know of any loan that you paid, how much is interest and how much is principal, so that you can deduct only the interest in certain cases. You can also use it for goal setting, like if you want to pay down credit cards and you want to decide how much money to pay each month to have the credit card paid off by a certain date. For example, if you take a truck loan and you are borrowing $36,000, and the finance company that gives you the truck loan charges you a 12% annual rate, that means that it would be 1% of the balance of the loan compounded monthly. And that's the way most companies would do it. You will try to pay it off in 48 months, and you will try to make a payment of $1,000 per month. Now, the reason I say try is because you don't know exactly what the numbers will be until you put them into the loan manager. If the payment amount is not enough for the time period you chose, then you will need a balloon payment at the end to pay off the loan by the date you want to finish. If the payment amount is too much for the time period of the loan, then you just need fewer payments to pay off the loan. So, first we have to set up the file for the loan. We have to put in a liability account for the balance, we have to put in the bank account for the payments, we have to put in an interest expense account for the interest, and we also have to put in a bank fees expense account for any fees that we have to pay that does not count as interest, but money we pay for the service of borrowing that we never get back. So getting back to our example, we need a liability account in the chart of accounts called truck loan, and we have to make the balance $36,000. And again, here's the rest of the information about the loan. Let's take a look at how we would set up the file. If we first open the chart of accounts, you can see I have already prepared the accounts that we need. I already put in the chart of accounts an account called truck loan, and I made it long-term liability. I also already have a Chase bank account, which can be the bank account that the payments come from, and of course the two expenses are already here, bank fees and interest expense. If you don't have this in your chart of accounts, take a moment to put them into your chart of accounts in the way that we learned from the previous videos. Now let's imagine in our example that we borrowed this truck loan for $36,000 on June 1 and we put the money into the Chase bank account. Well, that's very simple. So let's go to the Chase bank register, put the date June 1, okay? Whatever transaction number would be there doesn't matter. The payee can be Chase Bank, okay, the account. Now, the account that the money is going into is truck loan, and this is a deposit to Chase Bank for $36,000. And the reason we have $36,000 more in the Chase Bank account is because of this long-term liability truck loan. Now when I click record, you can open the trial balance and you can see that truck loan shows up for the first time on the trial balance with a $36,000 balance at the beginning of the life of the loan, and now Chase Bank now has $38,000. You would then write a check to buy the truck. We won't actually write a check from Chase Bank to buy the truck. We'll focus more on the actual loan. Now let's remember the conditions of the loan that we're trying to make, and let's see how we would set it up in the Loan Manager. From the main menu, click Banking, Loan Manager, and the Loan Manager window opens up. We have no loans in the Loan Manager yet, so we click Add a Loan. The first question the Loan Manager asks us is, which liability account is currently holding the balance of the loan? In this case, we only have the truck loan. The lender can be Chase Bank, and the date that we actually borrowed the money, as you well know, is June 1, and the original amount we borrowed is $36,000. Now, we have to decide how many months it'll take us to pay this off. This will affect the amount of the payment and everything else. So let's say, for example, we want to pay this off in 48 months. That's 4 years. We then click Next, and then we put the date of the next payment. Well, if we borrowed the money on June 1 and we're paying monthly, probably the first payment comes in July 1. Now, let's see what happens if we decide to make our monthly payment $1,000 for those 4 years. Click Next. Now, over here we put the annual interest rate. If the pay period is monthly, QuickBooks will turn it into a monthly rate. So let's leave monthly for now and put in the percent, the annual percent that the bank is charging. And again, if it's monthly and it's 12%, we know that it'll be 1% of the balance compounded, added to the balance every month. When we click Finish, before we click Finish, we have to put what account the payments are coming from, that's Chase Bank, what account the interest expense is going into, well, that's interest expense, and what account are we going to pay or record any fees that relate to this loan, that's not interest, bank fees. Then when we click Finish, we now have all the information about the loan here in the summary. Now let's click the payment schedule and see what goes on. Well, if our payment is $1,000 each time, and we're starting off borrowing $36,000, that means out of the first payment of $1,000, $640 will reduce the principal to a lower balance, and $360 out of that $1,000 is just interest that the bank will keep forever. If we scroll all the way down, we can see that even though we told QuickBooks we want to pay it off over 48 payments, QuickBooks says we only need 45 payments, where the last payment can even be less than $1,000. Now, why is it a little bit fewer payments? Well, based on the numbers, if it's 12% per year and we're paying $1,000 a month, mathematically, we will pay off the loan before we get to 48 months. We'll pay off the loan between 44 and 45 months if we're paying $1,000 a month. You may also notice in the first payment that if it's 12% per year, we know that it's 1% per month. So only in the first month, 1% of this balance is equal to $360, and that's the interest that comes out of the first payment. That means out of the first payment of $1,000, the principal will be reduced by the difference, which is $640. Notice every subsequent payment, the amount of interest you pay gets lower because the principal is lower after each payment, and that means the amount you reduce the principal gets more and becomes more and more for each payment. These are things you would learn if you study from a finance or accounting class what happens when you make payments for the same amount to decrease a balance when there's compound interest. Let's change it and see what happens. Let's see what happens if we make the monthly amount a little bit smaller. We can click Edit Loan Details, leave this information, and click Next. And let's make the monthly payment $800 instead. When we click OK and come back to the payment schedule, we see each payment is $100, but you can see the interest amount of that payment is the same because that's your arrangement with the bank. When we scroll all the way down, perfect. Okay? So, actually it's not perfect. We told QuickBooks we only want to make 48 payments, and we told QuickBooks we can only afford $800 a month. That means at the end, there's going to be a balloon payment of $9,862 left over if we only make $800 a month payments under this circumstance. We know that we only want 48 periods, so that means that we will have a big balloon payment at the end if the monthly payment we choose is too small. We can also find out more about what might happen if we change some of the information in the loan. You can click What If Scenario, and in this particular loan, you can see if you change your payment amount, what will happen. If we make our payment amount 900 and click calculate, notice we now have a smaller balloon payment and the overall amount of interest we will pay is less because we're paying more during the life of the loan. We don't want any balloon payments, so now let's make it 950 and then click calculate. Now we don't have any balloon payment at all. Let's see what happens if we actually change the loan. Click Edit Loan Details, click Next, and make the monthly payment $950. We know we won't have a balloon payment, and when we come down here to the bottom, now we see this is as close as we can get to the circumstance that we want. So, if the bank is charging 12% interest, and we're borrowing $36,000, and we're making monthly payments for 48 payments, the closest we can get to paying off the loan in exactly 48 payments would be to make sure the payment amount is $950. Just look at the schedule. We go down to 48 payments and every payment is $950 except the very last one, and that's pretty close to $950 for the last payment. So by playing around with the numbers in this way, you can decide how much you want the monthly payment to be, or how many periods you'll pay it off based on the amount you're borrowing and the amount the bank charges. Now let's make our first payment on July 1. Well, how do we do that? The loan manager will help us. Click on the first payment that we're supposed to make, and of course, in this case, $360 of the $950 that we pay will go into interest expense, and the balance, the principal of the truck loan, will decrease by $590 and go down to something like $35,400 or $300 whatever dollars. How do you make the payment? Well, all you have to do is click Set Up Payment. And because the first payment was selected, the information from the first row is here. We're paying $950, but $360 will go into interest expense, and $590 will go to decrease the balance of the loan. When you click OK, the Write Checks window opens up. Notice it has all the information that you would normally put in the register. And after you save this payment, because it is assumed that you wrote check number 7 for $950 and mailed it out, But QuickBooks is showing you if you record it this way and put it in this window, QuickBooks will distribute the $950 by decreasing the bank account by $950, but decreasing the truck loan only $590 and putting in $360 into interest expense. And if we click save and close, oh, we have to put the date we're actually paying, which is July 1. And if we click save and close, QuickBooks will save it and will also put this check in the check register the same way that all the other checks from Chase Bank are in that register. Look what happens when we click save and close. Then of course we just click yes. Don't worry about this advertisement, just click cancel. Now, we close out the loan manager and open up the trial balance. Notice the balance of the truck loan has decreased from $36,000 to $35,410. And notice for the very first time, interest expense is now on the trial balance at $360. You may also notice if you open the Chase Bank register that the balance has gone down on July 7th from $38,000, decreased by $950 to $37,050. You may also notice that right here is the check that we just wrote, except in the account column it says split because the checks window split the $950 between interest and principal.